All right, YouTube. So,
little update video on the W990.
Just made 50,000 kilometers. I'm at 50,023. I guess that's about 30,000 miles. So, I got this truck brand new. Another guy drove it for two or three rounders. But that was it, because I was off that week when I tried something new. And to date, the only real repair that this truck has had that could have left me down was there was a fray in my fan belt. I don't think it was put on right from day one, right at KENWORTH factory. Other than that, I've been pulling the same trailer, four axle Timmons, and it has been flawless for 50,000K. No problems whatsoever. No complaints either. It's a steerable axle, four axle Timmons, and it's got a set forward kingpin on it. So I got about a 25-inch setback on my kingpin, which I actually really like, because you can get the logs over the front further if you need it. Yeah, so as for the truck, no repairs to date that were needed. Never broke anything. Never wore anything out. Nothing really needed any adjusting. Only upgrades we've done is a Big Mac boost bumper, a real heavy duty one, and a Big Mac headache rack and chainsaw box. And we added some mud flaps behind the front wheels, all the way across from one side to the other. All that stuff staying on real good. So, as for the overall fit and finish of the truck, oh, we added hood straps, that's right too. The Western Star hood straps, because the hood was flopping in the beginning. And those extra Western Star hood straps made a night and day difference. So if anybody has a KENWORTH T880, T680, or W990, adding those two extra straps is highly recommended. Did a real good job for mine.
Sit up the clutch. We got a hydraulic over
air, or air over hydraulic slave cylinder clutch on it, and the bleeder valve is in the wrong place. It's very easy to get knocked off by a stone deflecting off a tire or stick or anything like that. So for the bush, not so good on that idea. For the highway, probably not a bad idea. Probably all right, unless you run over a field tire or something like that. Works really nice, really easy to push, all that stuff. I like that part. Transmission shifts real good. So, don't really like the position of the bleeder valve, and there should be a guard on it. So, maybe that's one thing we can do is make a guard for it. ABS is absolutely horrible. Absolutely hate the ABS system on this truck. I could meet the guy that designed it at Bendix Brakes, I'd punch him in the face. It's that bad. It's good on the highway. When you drive in the bush, on logging roads and ice roads, and places where you need full control of your truck and you have to be the boss, ABS is no darn good for nothing. So, don't like the ABS. Not at all. Not one bit. I also don't like the idea that I don't have a shut off the front brakes on my steer axle. Very, very handy upgrade for a logging truck to have something like that. And it's very important in my eyes. Because when you do spin out on a hill, you have control over your front wheels before you start backing up. You can shut off the front brakes and still be able to steer while you're backing down if you're on the brakes. Starts to run away and the wheels are locked up, you can't steer. So front brake disconnect valve on all logging trucks should be allowed, but I guess the government doesn't allow it here. But that's something that I'd really like to have on my truck. And then there's the anti-rollover protection system on these new trucks. This job, hauling logs out of the bush, there's times when you have to run a hill, which means get a lot of speed built up and take a chance and give her heck up the hill, so you don't spin out and have to back down or whatever. And if the hill's rough, it'll set off that traction, that vehicle stabilization control. And it'll spike the brakes on the trailer, and you almost go over a handlebar through the windshield. Other thing is too, like say you just drive a little too aggressive into a corner to climb a hill, and you turn a little bit too much G-force, and you know you're good, and you're expecting it to turn and go up the hill. It's quite the friggin' surprise when the truck cuts all the power, basically turns off the fuel pedal, and you can't pull that trailer around the corner. Brakes slam on, and again, you feel like you're going over handlebars and through the windshield, because when it comes on, it really comes on. So, in these new style trucks with the vehicle stabilization, you got to be ready for that to come on, because if you're on ice road, and trailer brakes come on, guess what goes in the ditch? You pull an ice road trucker fake going the ditch thing there, and your trailer takes off to the right or to the left, whatever way it can, and you're in trouble. So there's my gripes. ABS and the vehicle stabilization system is absolute crap. If I could shut it off, I would. And if I could meet the guy at Bendix Brakes that designed it, I would totally punch him in the face. Unless he was bigger than me. I'd just run away. No, I'd probably punch him anyway. Not bad at it. Very, very bad stuff. So anyway, here we are. 50,027. There we go. 62 liters per 100. That's what I'm getting now. And we're loaded and coming out. Right on. Have a good night, YouTube.